Welcome to Rebuild My Church Again, RMCA Bishop channel. May God bless you for opening this channel and listening to this spiritual talk. Therefore, now please relax and keep an internal calm. Surrender all your problems and worries at the foot of the cross. As you listen this talk, God will show you mercy. My dear friend, let us read from Matthew 14 verses 26 to 30. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, "It is a ghost." And they cried out for fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Be of good cheer. It is I. Do not be afraid." So he said, "Come." And when Peter had come down out of the boat, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But he saw that the wind was boisterous. He was afraid. And beginning to sink, he cried out, saying, "Lord, save me." Dear friend, now Peter, the apostle, began to sink because he took his eyes off Jesus and focused on the waves all around him. This is to say that the world or worldly attractions cannot save us. What they do is to distract us from Jesus, and then we fail. We begin to sink into the problems that the world and worldly allurements give us. It is because of this the faith failed in its practical applications. Peter began to sink because his faith faltered. His focus on Jesus got distracted. He lost the connection with Jesus because of the world around him. So what did Peter do? He came to his senses like the prodigal son. He remembered the past. He understood that when his focus and attention was on Jesus, he was able to do the impossible, walking on the water. Therefore, quickly he regained his faith and strength and began to focus on Jesus once again. He fixed his attention on Jesus again. It was at that moment Jesus reached out to him and saved him. Similarly, what we need to do when we are in trouble, in difficulties, is to come to our senses and restore our attention onto Jesus and keep the eyes fixed on him. Then Jesus will reach out to us and save us. There is no other shortcut than refocusing on Jesus. Here we learn a lesson. It is clearly verbalized in 2 Corinthians 5:7. "For we walk by the faith, not by sight." In short, now we may not be walking on water, but when our troubles, difficulties, sicknesses, financial debts, family disputes, jealousy of neighbors, attacks from enemies and his friends surround us, all what we need to do is not to focus on them, but placing our faith in Jesus and in him alone. If we do so, we will start walking on the waters and we will not sink at all. So my friend, if you are facing difficulties and troubles surrounding you, then keep your eyes on Jesus' power rather than your own problems. Similarly, when you are apprehensive about the future, never doubt Christ's presence or His great ability to save you. Remember that He is the only one that can really help you or save you or redeem you in whatever situations that you may be. And therefore, cling on to Jesus, and that is our saving point. Let me conclude this reflection with a verse from 1 Corinthians 16:13. Watch, stand fast in the faith, be brave, be strong. Let all you do be done with love. That's all for today. Keep maintaining the calmness that you experience in your heart at this moment and receive my apostolic blessing. Please forward this talk to others for their benefit immediately after receiving this blessing. Please listen one more talk if possible after some time. It will bring you more God's blessings. Now, please make an intention for an urgent need of this day in your heart. My blessing is for that prayer which you have placed before the Lord. Okay, so here we go. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Wishing you a good day. Yours in the mission of the church, Bishop Franco Mulakil.